Hello there, everybody. How's it going? I'm Voyam Duty Gledge coming to you today. Today I am playing as Renekton. Renekton, it means the tin can, that's the joke. In the top lane, who am I against? We have Vladimir. Oh, Joyous. Oh, Joyous. Joyous world. Welp. This is gonna be cancer. Let's take a look at the teams here. We have Renekton top, that's me, in case you were curious. Me, Renekton, the one and only. Janie to carry. Rammus jungle. Braum support. He's grassively and dying as well, which is interesting. Aurelion soul mid, they have Lucian AD carry. Zed mid, Vladimir top, Aurelion soul jungle, and Morgana support. Who went bottom stone, funnily enough, which could very well backfire because I don't think you want to take more damage as Morgana. Don't know if that's a good point, good decision. Hopefully that backfires in her, and if I was their bot lane, I would just focus the shiz out of Morgana because she can potentially die really easily because that's an extra, how much, 4%? Yeah, 6%. It's also 4% damage reduction though, so maybe I'm just missing out. Maybe I'm just missing out on the whole plan of action. Hey, anyways, I was playing Renekton. It was either going to be Renekton or Lissandra. Starting to wish I went Lissandra so I can actually just stay far behind and get CS without having to deal with this cancer champion. I should stop saying those things. Yeah, he's an annoying champion, okay? Vladimir is an annoying champion. That's all I'm trying to get at. And I don't like him. So yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. We're going to queue those minions so we can actually get them. And good news immediately. And this is actually legitimately good news. He's not an aggressive Vladimir. That actually does me a lot. That may sound silly, but he should be like really aggressive right now, and he's not, which is a blessing because it's gonna make this lane a lot more tolerable. Let's just say. I guess it doesn't matter when I go second. I guess I might as well get my E so I can maybe kind of go in on him here and make some grand stuff happen in the world. Though of course I can't guarantee this stuff will be too grand, but we'll hopefully it'll be a little bit grand. And I did go Doran Shield because his Q is a single target spell, which does mean it blocks 8 damage. Even if it's not much damage, it's still 8 damage. The guy to consider these things. I didn't do the dinkin' minion. Get me out of here! Okay. It's fine. It's fine. Alright, that was a bit tricky to get all those, but we will survive. And we'll W that and go ahead and ward right over here because, for all I know, Aurelion Soul might be very close to my location. He very well could try to kill me. Jeez, it does so little damage early game. Granted, I mean, look at that. It's like, Nehemiah isn't healing. Oh, healing himself for 3. That's pretty great. Just 3. Just such a small number. I don't think any building in the game heals so little. it's just the fact that it just says 3. And I'm not saying that's not, you know, nice. It's just kind of funny. Though, of course, Ferocity heals a lot more, I think. Heals to, 10. Because plus the 1 AD, which is nice. Rammus is going to continue doing his Rammus things, which is always dandy. We'll go ahead and do some damage to him there before vacating the premise. He did do a decent amount of damage with the Thunder Lord's proc, which upsets me a great deal, but that's okay. And you might have noticed I didn't back go Strength of Ages, which you don't really see on people that aren't jungle often, but I mean, it's at the end of the day, it still does give me a lot of sustain that I'm going to need against Vladimir, and it gives me a lot more tankiness that no other Amash would really give me. I could go something like Grasp of the Undying, sure, but like in the long term, Grasp of the Undying only really helps you in the lane phase primarily. Sure, it can help you in like a Roam or Saving the Clutch, but mostly helps you in the lane phase, while Strength of Ages gives you permanent tankiness, which is nice. Like, I would have 900 health right now, but I had 920. 920. That's just amazing. That's just high quality stuff. So I know how Aurelion Soul ganks are supposed to work because he can fly over walls and then stun you with his Q. So I still don't think he's a good jungler, but I know how he can. I know how his ganks can, you know, work. So because I know how his ganks can work, I should be a little bit wary of them. I don't know. The problem is I don't really know enough about Aurelion Soul to know what walls he can fly over. Can he just fly over that large, like, piece of rock there? Because I'm not sure if he can. He very well could. I'm not saying I don't think he can. I just straight up don't know. which is ignorance is generally not a good thing to have in League of Legends. We have First Blood going down to the Morgana thanks to a Rammus Braum crazy combo killer, if you will. And he is starting to poke me a lot more now, which upsets me. It upsets me a great deal. Oh, wait, no, this is starting to look like it's not going to end well. This is starting to look like it's not going to end as well as I was hoping it would. And Braum is... It looked like he was just standing there, and then Aurelion kind of flashed after and finished the job. I would have teleported down, but I'm pretty confident I wouldn't have died, or I wouldn't have been able to get the kill. I mean, I probably could have, like, burned everything, but I might have died in the process. I don't know. It seemed a bit finicky, but apparently that went a lot worse than I thought it was going. Which is interesting when that kind of stuff occurs. So, two kills for the Aurelion Soul, and one kill for Morgana. I guess at least Lucian did any kills, but still three assists for him, which is, you know, it's nothing to sneeze at, if you will. Granted, I don't know why you would sneeze at something happening in a game. That seems a bit fishy. I'm going to proc my potion because he's en route. I don't know if I want to go in yet, but we'll try. So let's just go in, kind of go all in here, and he is leaving. There's the flash. He's going to proc the Q, maybe? Nope, there it is. Don't die, please. That'd be nice. And, oh, so close! But we shouldn't dive that. Oh, I did not think that was going to be as close as it did. If I knew that, I would have flashed. But again, kind of a problem with new champions. You don't really know what they're necessarily capable of, which is a shame because that means that pretty much mid-turret just took a bunch of damage. You didn't really get anything out of it. So maybe I probably should have gone more aggressive, but I didn't think it was going to go as well as it did. Oops. Oh, well, we'll move on. We are definitely going to rush, like, crazy town magic resistance. I'm gonna do everything in my power just to deal with this dang Vladimir. Plus they have an Aurelion Soul jungle and a Morgana, so I can justify going to magic resistance sign first. Plus, you know, Sphere of Sage actually is pretty good on Renekton because of course it gives him that beautiful healing stuff. The unique passive actually does help. Even if, you know, 20% 6 is like what it increases by 2. You know, it's not much. It won't increase my heal by much at all. Of course, that's not the reason I'm going it because... Oh, I got it! I can't believe I got it! I'm going it because of the magic resist primarily. But of course, overall, Spear of Resist is just a really good item because it gives a lot of health and other delicious stats, as you are all probably very aware at this point. I'm going to miss that because I'm garbage tier and I'm mad because I'm bad. And now we're going to hope we can acquire these, which I would hope we can. He's going to continue being a cancer champion, which, you know, I'm not going to hesitate calling him that because he's a rude individual and I don't really like him very much. Alright. And he got executed. Welp. That's a bit awkward. Could be worse, I suppose, but, you know, what are you going to do? Zed is continuing to dominate his lane, which is upsetting. He only has one kill, but Aurelion Soul is not exactly doing extremely well for himself. That's all I'm necessarily getting at. Out of that minion way too early. And of course, here we see the problem with me being a top laner. You just kind of chill up here and hope one day some good things will happen, but you don't know if good things will happen. You're pretty much just going to sit here for like a few million years, and you know, you don't know if it's going to be a good few million years or a bad few million years. It's just a crazy situation for everybody involved, and I just don't know what to do. I just don't know what to do about it, but it's okay. We'll use our Cold and Meek or whatever the heck it's called, and I would teleport bot, but there's no ward, so I can't really. Well, there's one right there, but I don't think that's going to really result in much, let's be entirely honest here. So we'll just go back and get the Kindle Gem, because Vladimir has quite a bit of pushing to do, and he's not necessarily doing it very fast, so I might as well just take my time, you know, take in the sights and sounds, and have a Merry Christmas. But I'm certainly watching the bot lane. Aurelion Soul is going to try to roam again, which very well could work this time. Very well could. Again, I would teleport if there was a ward here, but right here, I don't think I would do anything. So there is an Aurelion Soul there as well, an exhaust from ours. That very well could have gone absolutely terribly. And I mean, his turret did die because of that roam, so I don't know if this is necessarily working out entirely. There's the Aurelion Soul going full speed ahead. Is it going to work out for him? I don't know. I should probably pay attention to what's going on here. And also ping that Vladimir is MIA. So we have one, a kill for a kill. Yeah, kill for a kill. Kill in the mid lane. Ram is solo killing the Zed. That's nice. Don't know where Vladimir is. I'm assuming he just left. And, welcome to the exciting top lane experience of League of Legends, where you sit here and you show these minions who's boss. Oh, well, but mister, is there anything else that we could do? Well, you could roam, but it likely will usually result in not really much, so that'll pretty much be the end of that. I'm on my way, though, so pretty much get ready to rumble, you jokesters. Aw, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? It was so close. It was so close. Oh. All right, nice calling. Nice calling. Real just made you look great, buddy. All right. Now is when you guys push more because you're just standing there, Jin. You're just standing there. Would have been better if you pinged first, though. Eh. I guess he is right. I probably should have pinged so he could ult or something. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry. I should have pinged, actually. Because I'm always the kind of person that's like, why don't you just ping? It's so simple to do. What the heck is wrong with you? And then I just don't. But good idea. Well, thanks, Jin. At least he's not like, you idiot, why didn't you ping? Why didn't you ping? I would just be like, I forgot this one time. I'm sorry. Get out of my way, you stupid minions. All right. Let's continue our escapades here. Oh, great. Good job, Vladimir. Your camping the bush technique really scored you like a 10,000 bonus points. Really just makes you look like a fantastic individual. 10 out of 10, 20 out of 20, 15 out of 15. And here we see, this seems to be the theme this game. Only this time it's because of Vladimir roaming that kind of made things go south. And of course I was not there to really save the situation. So that's going to be Vladimir getting a kill, which is a shame of course because I just roamed and barely didn't get a kill. I mean, my roam, it still burned a flash, but of course it's not necessarily hugely amazing when comparing to how his roam went. What do you think I'm flipping doing? I can't necessarily push extremely fast as we're necking, let alone do much damage since I'm rushing Spirit Visage, so I apologize, but I'm pretty much just going to be doing very mediocre damage to this turret. And we're also going to like run away from this jokester because he's just kind of a rude dude and I don't really appreciate him. He's kind of like shooting arrows at me and I'm not exactly hugely fond of it. My E is not up yet, but when it is, I will consider going in. Oh, there's pink there. Well, that explains the whole situation. Is Rammus going in again? What is going on? Rammus is 3-1-2. This guy's out of control. Granted, he is a ninja, so it's pretty hard to see his gang, so you know, I guess when you consider things in a realistic point of view, it makes a lot more sense. Alright, let's just keep following these minions for a few years, and one day I'm sure we'll get so tanky that they won't know what to do. I may have autoed the wrong minion there. I apologize, but, you know, I can own my mistake and understand that it was very silly of me to do something like that. But I will have to move on and understand that everybody makes mistakes. Something motivational speech, thank you. And we'll paint that Vladimir is still MIA. I'm assuming he's actually coming back soon. It's also possible Zed could be coming down here. That'd be very weird. Alright, yeah, there you are. Alright, I'm gonna leave though because Zed is still MIA, so we should probably place a ward here. At the end of the day, I do not have armor yet, so Zed would probably do a flip ton of damage to me, and I'd prefer to avoid that large amount of damage if at all possible. I can go back and get Merc Treads and Spirit Visage soon, which will be nice. He is going Haunting Guys soon, so he can Haunting Guys next, so he can actually do the damages to me that he's striving for as a soul Vladimir man, and I don't like it one bit, but I can't really change his perspective on life, so there's also that. And I would like, oh no, we're going, so there's the taunts, and I do have my other dice that we're just going to kind of throw in on him, and is this going to get a kill? It's going to get a kill, get the kill, okay. Well, I'm horribly dead, but I went for it, and then Rammus is going to die because, well, Aurelion Soul also showed up, so that was just a huge inconvenience for everybody involved. Well, I mean, I can buy my items now, I guess. But now my turret's gonna die because Zed is, you know, pretty good at what he does. our Aurelian Soul is doing his best to make good things happen. So it's a mid turret for a top turret, pretty much. So debatable how worth it that is. But it is pretty upsetting that Zed is now able to get two turrets, which is just very annoying to deal with. He's also just a 3-in-1 Zed in general, which is going to be very upsetting to deal with overall. Let's throw out a prediction in this game. I was going to just predict straight up if we're going to win or lose, but I feel like that's going to be very pessimistic / optimistic, just predict that straight away, because saying this game's 9-9. I was going to say, the game's so far in their favor, I would say, because they seem to have a lot bigger of a hold on objectives, and no offense to our mid laner, but I don't think he's going to be doing a whole lot this game. That just seems to be, like, the feeling I'm getting, which, whether that's accurate or not, I'm unsure, but that's the feeling I'm getting regardless. So there you go. Whether that means he'll come back and show me who's boss is very, you know, it's all things that we can make happen in this world. So we're gonna maybe go down here and see what we can make happen. And there we go, there's the kill, and there's the kill. Ooh, I actually got that one, sweet. And hello there. Hello, Aurelian Soul, how are you doing on this fine day? I hope the answer is relatively mediocre, because I don't like it if you're doing okay, honestly. Upsets me a great deal. Are we gonna dive this? I don't know how I feel about diving this. I feel like we should just get the turret, maybe. Oh, Vladimir's en route. I don't know. I feel like now's when we should run. I feel like now is the good time to just run. Oh, would you stop it with your nonsense, Aurelian Soul? Oh, no, there's the Zed. There's the exhaust, though. There's the exhaust. Do they have Vladimir under control? If they didn't, he's under control now, and we actually didn't lose anybody there, which is amazing. Honestly, if I was Vladimir, I would have just kept pushing and made it so like one of us had to go up there. But, you know, why'd you exhaust me? What? Why'd you exhaust me? That was a very strange choice to exhaust the Renekton tank, who wasn't even binded, so yeah, I don't know. I don't know, that was a close call there, bucko. Alright, Dragon is gonna have some issues here. I don't know if we can stop them, considering our rams just went back, but me being here should maybe cause them a little bit of worry. Have to give it up, I think. I don't know, I don't know if they're actually actively doing it. It jokes on you, I still have slice and dice. Alright, well, that's about it. Okay, I'm still tanky. They stole the blue, but now our team is actually here. They didn't choose to do the dragon, which is nice. But also, I am very quickly starting to get poked down, and it's not really working out very well for me. So if you can stop doing your nonsense, that'd be fantastic, Aurelian Soul. And we're just going to kind of do some damage there, and oh no! Kill her! Kill this lady! Kill this lady! Aw, oh, Jiminy Christmas! I'm alive! Aw! Piercing light hit me, but the heal did more! Okay. This is definitely gonna be good for us. Alright, that was... I can't believe I lived there, though. That much is for sure. And for one of my building first, it doesn't recommend Sunfire on Renekton anymore? What the? I don't know why the heck it doesn't recommend Sunfire, because in my opinion, it's still a really good item on him. Maybe I'm just missing something, though. Why are you guys not doing Dragon? Okay, I mean, I guess we don't have our jungler, but, like, that would have been a really free Dragon. I guess it was, like, Bot Turtle Dragon, but I feel like I really, really do feel like that was a free Dragon, so... I didn't paint or anything, because I assumed that's what they were going to do, but, you know, maybe I'm missing something. Maybe they're weaker than I thought, but, like, Braum had a decent amount of health left, and Jin is Jin. I don't know. It would have been more worth it if he got the dragon, but that's okay. It's not dead. I was like, wait, maybe they actually killed it. Nope. I don't know. Differing. I do not agree with the decisions that were made on that particular situation. We have 132 CS, and we are pretty dang tanky now. After Sunfire, we might just go... just straight up Randuin's, maybe? Probably. I mean, Randuin's is always a solid item, so I can probably afford to do something like that. Now they're doing Dragon. See, this is what I was afraid of. The fact that they were just going to do it immediately afterwards. That is indeed a Zed, so we're going to, kind of run away from him, and he's gonna that's gonna just gonna be the end of that conversation. So I'd appreciate if you didn't do that. I don't know. I'm not gonna try like dwell on it, but I don't know. Just well, maybe we can get some kills out of this. It's possible. It is possible. Unlikely for sure, but you know they're certainly going for it, and you know as long as they're going for it, the possibility is there. And we will also head on over here in the mid lane. We know Zed's ultimate is down, and Jhin is actually 10-1 now. So, you know, that's a thing. That is definitely a thing. We'll pretty much just show our faces here and defend mid, and we'll show our faces top and defend that lane. So we are the defender top, or defender top lane of the century is basically what I'm trying to get. You can give me awards, medals, everything that you wish to give me, I will accept. And then we'll recall because I'm an alligator. Woof woof. And we'll buy our Sunfire cape, and it'll be great. Bada bing, a bada boom. So honestly, I could afford to go an offensive item now. I have like two very good tank items. The question is, do we? Plus, we have Rammus, who's pretty much always going to go full tank, which gives me reason to build some damage. But we also don't really need more damage. But at the end of the day, Jhin is also all right, so we kind of do. So I don't know. I might go one damage item, or like a sub damage item like Black Cleaver, but I've never found Black Cleaver to be very great Armanectin, at least the new one. So, you know, we'll see. Those shurikens both barely missed me, and I like it. I like it a great deal. I don't know if anything crazy is going to happen here. I saw Morgana en route, which makes me have pause about going here. This tank Morgana build, Aegis of the Legion, Stone, Bond of Stone, Sword of Insanity is this, I don't actually know. I'm gonna like waltz on over here because I don't really want to deal with you considering Aurelion Soul is nearby. Granted, Aurelion Soul is kind of like just running away, so maybe it's fine. No big, everyone needs gold. Look at the positivity of this Jhin, he's out of control. First, he doesn't call me a scrub for not pinging when I'm teleporting, and now this. The sheer sportsmanship is what I'm getting at. Yeah, I don't know if I want to like kind of go in here, because I don't think it'd really go very well, but oh, there's a Rammus here. Are we going? This is a 3v5, guys. I don't know how I feel about this particular situation. No. Yeah, this is exactly what I had, and I did not think that was going to go well at all. Frankly, I don't know why I kind of went in with them. I guess, you know, maybe to help out in the whole situation. Oh god, Morgana. You think I don't look at mini-maps? What do you think this is? You think this is a game? Oh no, yeah, well, I was hoping I could save him quickly enough, and then I just wasted flash by doing that. That was a terrible engagement. I don't get it. I don't get what that was for, but definitely not an ideal engagement. But I think I'm gonna go tanky more. Probably Dead Man's Plate. Rom, stop flying. You're not a bird. I know you want to be a bird. I think everybody wants to be a bird at some point in their life. But I am not a fan of large, muscular men. Oh, jeez. Frame rate, are you doing your thing again? Yeah, it's doing it again. What, you're going to tell me it's high encoding usage? Consider turning down settings. No, it's fine, I assure you. You work sometimes and then you don't work other times. You've got to understand the OBS. That this stuff just doesn't make sense that you're doing this. Well, hold on, let me turn off Steam, turn off Skype. You'll probably hear Skype do its nonsense. Sorry, friends, this Jhin is just out of control. The frame rate's probably really low right now. All right, is it good now? Maybe it's good now. Oh, yeah, well, there's a little bit of stutter there. And well, hopefully it kind of sorts itself out. I turned off everything I pretty much could, and it seems to be okay now, so you know, maybe we're good. Maybe we're good now. You know, what's the cooldown on Aurelion Soul's expand star thing? Because it feels like it's pretty low. Feels like it is indeed pretty low. We're going to use our ultimate here because it looks like we're having a very funky engagement going on. And then, once again, it probably is not an engagement that will really win because Jhin is not here. Plus, there's the Vladimir ult, which we'll just walk away from to make it so it doesn't actually work. That will avoid that and go and do some stuff there and use a slice and nice there and get a stun off there. And the auto attacks, a kill for a kill. Jhin ultimate going off. Oh, that looks... Oh my! Yeah, no, you can't escape my bloody grasp! I'm sorry, what is it called? My ruthless predator-ness! Yeah, I don't know. Alright, Zed is still alive. I am very tanky though, so I don't think he can necessarily deal with me properly. I was gonna head top of the railing, Soul has that covered. I should just call him Soul. I should really just call him Soul. And you should really stop your nonsense there. Ignite is not gonna kill me. Burns do nothing to my soul. I have seen much war in this war. Alright, what's going on over here? Project Bofa? What does that even mean? I don't know, but it's funny, I guess. We're gonna get rid of our dead man's plate so we can be a speedy alligator and crocodile. What the heck? I think it's an alligator, right? I'm pretty sure it's an alligator. The only way I tell the difference is alligators have a lot bigger jaws, and this man has a pretty big jaw. He's not mine, but... He's not mine? Excuse me? I mean, it's true that he isn't mine, but... You know what? Let's just stop talking. You know what? You're that one species, that you're that prehistoric species that looks like an alligator. I forget what they're called. But they have, like, really, really long, thin jaws, even though it's clearly not what he is at all. It's a joke. Only Fly Guy 325. Fly Guys are weak, and they should feel weak. So... Pretty much get wrecked is basically what I'm saying. Dragon is indeed up. We should probably prepare for it if I had to guess. Oh, look at you with your red buff. Aren't you just a special snowflake? Stop it. I don't want to fight you guys yet. I'm not in a position to do that kind of stuff, okay? Don't you understand the kind of life I want to live? Of course you don't. There's flipping dragons flying everywhere. We're deciding that maybe we should be doing dragon when we definitely should not be. There's the culling. There's the good stun from the Aurelian Soul, the enemy team Aurelian Soul. So I don't really know what to think of that. There's the stun off. I'm tanking a whole ton, and yet we're losing anyway somehow. So that did not go very well. No, Jin, run. Run. Oh, Jiminy Christmas, why'd you do it? Why'd you do it? Why'd you do it? Yeah, well, you got two of them. I understand that Aurelian Soul stunned two of us, but, like, I was tanking... I feel like three of them for a good 8 seconds, and yet that fight was still lost, which, you know, I wasn't really able to see everything else that was going on, so I can't really decipher as to why things went the way they did. You know what skin I want? Cosmic Reaver Casting. Why am I saying this? You know what skin I want? You know what I want? I want one of these statues hanging from my wall. Let's go on over here and evaluate the decisions we made in life. Alright, we have a magnificent score of 4, 2, and 8. How flipping beautiful, but what do you expect as a tank Renekton? Probably not going to get ridiculously fed when you're a tank Renekton. You'll probably, as long as you're positive and or at least just equal, you're probably going to be useful. Maybe. I like that way of spelling maybe. It's a very funky way of spelling maybe. Alright, so Zed is down bot. He is very aware that we're going. He has the option of pushing bot more or trying to stop this nonsense. Rammus, yeah, Rammus can 1v1 Zed. I could probably 1v1 Zed. I don't know if I can 1v1 Zed and kill him, but I'm pretty sure I can 1v1 Zed and not die. Because I just have all that beautiful, beautiful armor. So, you know, I don't know. Morgana's thing's down. The exhaust has been wasted. The exhaust has been wasted. Where's your Thane pool? I don't know. I don't know what's happening. Oh god, I'm dead again. Please tell me this is gonna go well. Zed just kind of wrecked everybody as usual. So that probably had something to do with it. Jin is trying his best, but then he had to reload. I don't know. These fights keep going bad, and I feel like I don't know why. Is Zed not getting peel? Huh. Because I'm trying to do my, you know, be a tank and tank them. But should I be peeling? Should I just be staying next to Jin and peeling for him instead? I feel like that's what I should be doing. Vlad's too strong in team fights. That is true. That is very true. Rammus is going all out to kill this jokester. And it might actually work, which would be hilarious. But it'll more likely just get him killed. Yeah, well, you know, it's kind of expected, honestly. So let's just go mid instead. And they apparently decide not to do Baron off of that, which is an interesting decision. I haven't gotten to ult in a couple of them. Jin, should I just guard you? Because me being in the front doesn't seem to be working. That's I'm gonna ask him and see what he says. He is really fed, so you know, I'll let him be the deciding factor. I'm starting to think I should just tank the Vendom and just have Rammus in the front lines, but I feel like if just Rammus front lines, then you know, we'll have no front line. We kinda need a front line and a back line, but maybe we need more of a back line, I don't know. Jin isn't answering the question though, so it's kind of hard to tell what's going on here. Alright, let's eat out of that immediately and kind of prepare ourselves for whatever this is, which I don't know what this is honestly, but it's something for sure. Ag. Alright, well, oh no. Oh, Jiminy Christmas. Well, something stunned three of them at once. Why were we fine without any carries there? Good question. I have no idea. I wanted to disengage. But I don't know. It was Braum and Rammus, I think, that were like trying to push and engage for some reason. I don't know. That was a super bad fight. Yes, indeed it was. It was a very bad fight. Braum got wrecked before I could do anything. Geez, the throws are real. The throws are indeed real. I don't know if I can necessarily do a whole lot about the situation, but I'll try to be a little bit of a spooky factor and try not to die in the process. Yeah, sure. Sure. I mean, we do have people home guarding very soon, likely. And then I'm gonna die because Lucian crit me like 5 times. So, what's his crit chance? 50. 15, he crit me like 5 times. Granted, he is Lucian, but still. Come on. Alright, well, at least they both died at the end of the day. Huh. Whopping score 4-4-10. Madness, absolute madness. This is. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to build Steric's Gauge in time, but that's definitely what I think is a good call next, so that's what we're gonna do. And hopefully it'll work. No guarantee it will, but hopefully it'll work. Jin's gonna do his damages, and Zed's nowhere to be seen. That was a flash. I don't know what kind of flash it was, but it was a flash for sure. Jin's gonna like spin his little gun around, and I hope he's gonna enjoy spinning that gun around because it looks kinda cool. It's probably my favorite High Noon skin is Jin's. I don't really like any of the others. By the others, I mean the other two. But I don't know, I actually like High Noon Jin's, but maybe it's just because skins have advanced in quality so much. Alright. You guys got this, right? I would hope you guys got this because I'm gonna sit here and like slowly do damage to these minions. Very, very slowly. But it's still gonna be damage. I'm a tanky gator, so I understand the things I can accomplish in life. Let's go and just keep autoing them very slowly. There we go. And we'll kind of waltz on back and get Jarm's Fist, I suppose. Really want to get the Sterix as soon as possible. It should help me a great deal in living. Oh. Okay, I actually. Part of me is a bit concerned about Jin's build. He went Maw Malmortius, which I understand entirely as to why he did that. Because of Vladimir and Sol and whatnot, you know. But it doesn't really give him protection against Zed, which he really, really needs. So, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. They got the dragon, and we have Jin nearby. He's ulting in the distance. I don't know if it's really working necessarily. But that's okay. Proc our ultimate here. Doesn't matter too much if I get the binding on me. I'm still taking a lot of damage. Rammus died. Looks like we're still continuing going. Oh, frame rate. What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, I got it. It's a slideshow. We've entered the slideshow town. This is not good. This is not good at all. Help. 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 Just run. Flipping OBS. Why are you doing this? Now is not the time. Alright, just recall. Just recall and make it stop. Look, I thought no high encoding usage. And as soon as I check on you, you go away. And now you're at 60 frames again. Can you please explain yourself, OBS? Can someone please tell me why it's acting up for no reason? Because nothing about my computer has changed, and yet this keeps happening. Is there anything else I can close? Java update, cancel. Give me this Java update. Get Windows 10. Well, I can assure you I'm not getting Windows 10, so, you know, if you were hoping for me to get Windows 10, then I'm afraid to tell you that that's not going to happen. Jin apparently found Lucian and killed him, though, so that's pretty sweet. I hate this frame rate drop so much. I just want to record in peace. I don't make money off of doing this. I can't afford a processor. My processor is already, like, should be more than enough to handle League of Legends. I'll get you. Maybe I should try Fraps again. Because Fraps would just, like, go back to... would just go to, like, 1 FPS. And then I would just straight up know immediately it's going to break. But OBS is, like, halfway through the game. It's like, oh, yeah, no. We can't do this anymore. It's like, why? And it's like, eh, no, we're just going to... we're just going to randomly give you like 40 frame rate, and I'm going to be like, yeah, but why? And then they're going to be like, hey, you know, don't worry about it. And I'm like, I'm really worrying about it, so if you can please stop. Basically, what I'm getting at is I'm sorry for the technical difficulties. I find them really annoying, and if you do too, I apologize. I will try to get them resolved as per usual. I just went on about frame rate for like far too long, but at the same time, there's not a whole lot else happening, so... this is a concerning situation for sure. I don't know how this is going to really turn out. Jin's guy in chilling bot. Braum is probably dead. There's the Voice of Light, but an exhaust going out as well will probably just result in many, many people dying. Little W there, little stuff going on over here. We'll kind of waltz on over here and be a tanky fella once again. And if we can like get a flash... okay, well, the flash didn't really result in anything. There's the last bullet going off. I'm assuming we can take care of this jokester. Oh, he didn't use his hemorrhage yet, or whatever the heck it's called. I like it. Hemorrhage is named Darius Passive. What am I talking about? What am I talking about? I don't know. Just kill this guy. Could someone please kill this guy? Okay, that's one way for things to go down. I can get Starex now, so I'm gonna go do that. Our team should probably keep pushing mid, which is, you know, what they're doing, so that's fine. We'll home guard our way back. We still have Doran Shield as well, which is pretty silly. I like it a lot. Lucian, he has to be going back, right? Like, it has to be what he's doing. I like how Rammus was like, wait, nope, turn around. And then we quickly realized the error of our ways, and I slashed him upside the head and he died. Well, that could have worked if Rammus wasn't conveniently there, spinning at 1,000 miles per hour. So, you okay, guys? I can't teleport to Jin to traps. So, oh, there's a ward right there. Now, so far, he seems like he's doing all right. But now it doesn't seem like he's doing all right. So I'm going to go ahead and teleport here. And we're going to finish off this inhibitor. The Jin is conveniently not killed yet. Alright, well, you know, if you want to rub it in so much, then why don't you just say something, buddy? Alright, it's fine. Probably waste the teleport, because that was, like, very close, but I was afraid he was going to die, so... whoops. Reasons I don't play top lane, ladies and gentlemen. I'm also going to do some damage to you, and if we can get a kill on you, that would be very useful. And we killed Morgana. That's an extremely good catch-up there, and it was all me! And, well, the stun was all me, but the damage wasn't all me, but... that's just a tank in general. You're not going to be doing a whole lot of damage. What, closing the Java update work? I shouldn't jinx it. We also shouldn't die. I don't know. We're doing a good amount of damage to him. Oh, no. He just straight up died. He just died horribly there. And we are going to continue doing damage to you. That's going to be a Voice of Light. So never mind. If you want to be so passive-aggressive about it, then why don't you just say something? Because you did. Because it's the Voice of Light. That's the whole joke. All right. Let's continue our daily business. And... probably leave now. Let's avoid that. And Rylai's is so good on Aurelion Soul. Please, I can't move. Ah. Well, we stayed too long. We stayed way too long. So, super rip. Rylai's is like so good on Aurelion Soul. It makes him so annoying. Doesn't his? I think they already slow a little bit, but just making them slow that much more. Don't like it. Alright, last item. Probably Randuin's? Because I could really use some protection from these nonsense crits Lucian gives out. Yeah, we'll probably do that. It's that or Thornmail. Or even like Warmogs. Because the health regen from Warmogs is really good, but that's... I feel like... I shouldn't be looking for health regen necessarily, so we're not going to. Jin's asking for assistance. You probably shouldn't do that because it's just gonna wind up getting someone killed, which concerns me. So I think we're gonna go Randuin. Much as I like Warmog's heart regen, I think we're gonna. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. Because we do have a lot of mixed damage as well, so it depends. Oh my god. Ult do anything. They somehow killed Zed there. That's pretty great. But the enemy team did get Baron Nashor. But a dead Zed is a very useful thing. Very useful thing indeed. We're gonna like waltz on towards these guys and hope we can reach them eventually. It might take a few years, but you know, if we just believe in ourselves, and I'm sure one day it will find success in the world, and then we're gonna immediately leave because we are getting pretty low. Even though we are a tank, I would still appreciate living if at all possible. And I'm just gonna recall now. So that was a pretty fantastic situation. I hope you're all having a grand old time, but I'm leaving. Oh, Jin. Oh, Jin, are you okay, buddy? He's not okay at all. Oh my god. Yeah, let me just go in after our 80 carry's dead and just make it so we all die instead. Why'd they do that? Thought we had stuck together. I don't really. We just have to stall for minions. It wasn't really, you know, the first part of the fight. It was the part afterwards where Jin was here and, like, just died to Vladimir. And then for some reason, Sol. I cannot kill this dragon quickly enough, and I don't want to. For some reason, Braum and I don't remember who it was Rammus, Cerulean Sol, just kind of went in afterwards and like, let's finish the job. It's like, no, you guys don't do damage. Stop. I don't think I can. I don't know if this is a very ideal situation for me to be in. He does a lot of damage. Yep, there's Mr. Flying Dragon guy, so that dragon's all yours, and it's the fourth one as well, which is not good. I said the Java update did the job. Don't you not understand what I'm getting at when I say the Java did the job? It means the Java update did the job. That's the whole point. That is the whole point. But, yeah, we're just gonna kind of go over here. We see whatever your darn name is, Vladimir. I can't pronounce it for the life of me. Alright, we reach slideshow position again. And a fight's happening as well at the same time. Watch this. Watch this amazing fight that where you can't see what's happening. Alright. Just try to deal with this Zed. Try to deal with this Zed, and I stun people. I don't know if it worked. I can't tell what's happening still. This is beautiful. This is just absolutely majestic. Can't tell what's happening. Okay, well, that was a really big fight, and no one actually died from it, so interesting for sure. Don't think of it, but it's fine. Cotton, well, we're not going to be able to buy Randuin's for a while, so that's fine. I would love to just honestly straight up sell Merc Treads, but I don't know if it's going to work. Why are you lagging so much? It's like, this is like a stream right now, where I'm trying to moderate mid-time, and I can't tell what the problem is. So, yeah, oh no. Well, they just probably lost us the game. Why were you there? Why were they there alone? I don't know. I couldn't answer you this question. I really couldn't if I could, then, well, I won't be staying here right now, so. I'm pretty confident we're gonna lose now because of that, which is so stupid. That they just decided to go there. I guess I wasn't expecting to be mid so fast. There was no reason for you to be mid regardless, though. Like, I don't know. I just, that was very, very silly. Yeah, I can't move. Yeah, that's the game. Why were they mid? I don't get it. I just don't get it. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. If you did, make sure to like, comment, hit everything. Fantastic sale. Make sure to subscribe. You're on to raise the warmers of my heart. That was a nonsense way to lose. I don't know why OBS kept breaking. But I can't record anymore, so sorry if you don't like this, but it's what you're gonna get. How I feel right now is how flippin' Renekton feels. I hate computers and how they make no sense sometimes. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to like and whatever. I think I already said my outro. Have a great day.